Hello everyone. Today's Thursday Things is all about doing horse activities in the dark. For those who haven't met me before, my name is Marianne and I'm the founder of NaturalWilla, which is a source of information to help you to heal your horse mind, body and soul naturally. So today's topic on my Thursday Things is doing horse activities in the dark. Now, by horse activities I don't mean mucking them out, putting the hay up. What I do mean is exercises with them. Now, I don't want to say exercising my horse because it doesn't always mean exercising, and it doesn't, I don't like the word work because it's not work. I don't get paid to do things with my horses, to teach them things. It's a privilege, it's a joy. So I've gone with activities. So this is just my opinion and what I do. If you do something different, let me know in the comments below. I'd love to hear from you. Or if you do things a little bit differently, there's no judgment from me about what you do. This is just give you another idea, a different option, some food for thought maybe. So with the evenings drawing in and it being cold outside, you don't want to be outside as much. Now, I enjoy being outside, really, really, really enjoy it because Green Witch in me goes, yay, outdoors! And I do love it. But I also suffer from chilblains and Raynaud's disease. So I end up with very red fingers, I end up with chilblains on my tootsies, which are painful. So sometimes me being outside isn't always the best option. Now, doing activities with the horses, whether it's anything from backing them up or doing circle games or, you know, just even just brushing them, it's not as though you're doing a lot of movement. Even if you're riding, okay, there's a certain amount of effort that you put in, but it's still not as though you're running or charging about yourself. The main aim is to get the horse to do more than you are. So you're not really getting the blood pumping, you're not really just doing a hell of a lot. So I do get quite cold. So we're not talking about cold, we're talking about dark, but I've gone off on a bit of a tangent. But you can see where my mind is at when it comes to the winter months. I'm very concerned about my feet and my hands, and it's just not fun. And I don't think it's very fun for the horses either, particularly if it's peeing down with rain or something. They prefer to be stood in their stable and screw everything else. But I think you can't just stop doing things with your horses just because it's gone dark. Now, obviously, you don't want to be doing too much. You don't want to be, you know, riding in pitch black or anything like that. Now, saying that, I did ride the Major this evening. Now, him, I and Susie are putting something together for him to help him to just age disgracefully, shall we say. So I'm trying to get him to maintain some muscle so that he moves better, he has more confidence in his movement, and he weathers the winter better that way. That's my opinion. So we've got a little bit of a workout for him, which is very, very basic. Great for him with his body as a 28-year-old to just do a little bit, and for me to have that just interaction with him, just that small little conversation of, I would like you to do this. If you do this, then we're good. I'll put you back, I'll give you a lot of cuddles, I'll massage your back for you, and you can have a carrot because you're a clever sausage. Now, his activity is for me to ride him, and he does 5 steps forward, 2 steps back. So he gets used to putting effort into the forward, because the sooner he goes forward, the sooner he can stop. And he also puts effort into the back, because the sooner he goes back, the sooner he can stop as well. And the Major's motivation is, what can I do so that I can stand still? He's not one for charging around, he's not one for big energy things, he's very low energy. So that's what motivates him. So to trigger him to move better, I ask him to do very, very little. And it's interesting how quickly he goes from, oh, I knew that, to, yeah, okay. Oh, okay. Yeah, okay. Oh, okay. And it's interesting for me because I can start working my body differently on him and can say just a simple squeeze of the thighs and he walks forward and a lean of the back and he goes back. And it's great to have that communication with him and to have that understanding with him and to know that it's for his benefit. It's not me trying to get him to do stuff so that he looks amazing. It is for his health. So with that in mind, it's something that I need to be thinking about doing on a regular basis, which is fine because I love riding him. He's just so chill about life. But it doesn't mean that I have to do it in the dark because I don't have a flooded arena, I don't have flood lit everything. It's just, my little yard and a pitch black lane and things like that. Now, our eyes are predator eyes, so we recover from light to dark a lot faster than the horses do, which means that if I take the major out and go right, I'm sitting on you, and the floodlights are turned on because they're light act movement activated, it can make him a little bit momentarily blind if I'm not careful. And the same is the reverse as well. When we've moved out of range of the sensor, the motion sensor, he has to put a lot of trust in me because he suddenly can't see because his eyes take that longer. It's like, I think it's about 10, 15 minutes. I don't know. Don't quote me on that. Susie did tell me what it is. Better forget. But it's definitely a lot longer than us. So he then has to put trust in me when the floodlights go off. And I'm like, I'm just asking you to move 5 steps forward, 2 steps back, 5 steps forward, 2 steps back. So because I've got him into that rhythm, by the time I get there, he's good, he's golden. He trusts me by now. We've been together for 7 years. It's reasonably okay, and I think it's going to be a great signal for me if I'm getting something wrong, if he can't do a simple 5 steps forward, 2 step back when he can't see, and just trusting me to direct him. So I'm finding that even though it's in the dark, even though it's winter, and I'm doing a very, very small activity, it's meaning so much for both me and for him. And it's something that I'm going to continue doing, but obviously I'm not going to be as religious about it as I could be in the summer months because sometimes his back's going to be wet because he refuses to wear a rug unless it's frigging freezing and peeing down with rain. If you don't have that combination, he goes, "No, you're not putting that on me." And I trust him, and it's okay. It's okay for me to do that, and it's okay for him to say that. He knows what he needs more than I ever could. So, yes, some days I won't be able to do that, and that'll be fine. We might just do it on the ground, and I'll be directing him back and pulling him forward, and directing him back, pulling him forward, and that'll be okay as well. But I'm not sure what to do about the youngsters sometimes. I mean, Egypt is still having a little bit of issues with his lungs. So whilst I'm doing very low level activities with him, I am not sitting on him because I don't think that's fair. Now we have twigged onto a few things of what might be causing it, so we're working on it. But it's more groundwork for the youngsters at the moment, and that is also okay. And I'm also very much aware because I've been doing so much work on Naturally Willa. I know some over the past few weeks it might not have seemed like it. There's been very little in Facebook posts and YouTube videos, but that's because I've been focusing on other stuff, which has been most important, particularly on my own self, and just paring things back to what I can comfortably deal with without going bonkers. But it having that other focus means that sometimes I don't have all the time that I need to do with my horses. I do work a 9 to 5 Monday to Friday. I also do Naturally Willa at every spare moment I can find that also won't push me into a complete meltdown because I'm doing too much. So there's also times where I just need to sit. And that means that sometimes that my horses don't get activities. But if you think about it, my horses are just outside. So I see them in the morning, I see them at lunch, and I see them in the evenings. Now I know that that is an absolute privilege that not everybody has. But it's working and it's in the my favour because I have so much interaction with them on a daily basis that I can put boundaries in place that even in the dark they understand that they don't need to be in my personal space, that if we're walking down with a hay net, you're not to be thieving off me. If you're having a barney with each other, don't do it in my bubble because that freaks me out. Because that is in place, it's better. Now, I'm not saying that you should be with your horses more than you can fit into your day, but it does mean that I've been able to drop off some of the activities and pick them up when I can. But at the moment, that's in the dark. Which is helpful in some ways because it does limit the things and I don't get in my head of, I haven't done this, this, and this. I've only achieved A rather than A, B, C, D, E. Because it's dark and it's getting cold and the lights are annoying because the lights turn on at every frigging movement. And if you stop to let them relax and you stop to relax for too long and nobody moves, the lights turn off and you're like, if I move, they'll turn on. And it's helpful in some ways because it stops me from going over the top. But I've also got to be mindful of the fact that when the lights turn off, my horse is temporarily virtually blind for a bit. And then when the lights turn on, oh, that's a big bright light, and I've got to be mindful of that. So it's it forces me to think of so many things. It's not something that you think of on a day-to-day basis. And the only way that I thought about it or considered it was last year. I was taking the youngsters for a walk up the lane in the dark. And they were freaking out about it and go, oh, I'm not so sure about this. Oh, no. I asked Susie about it. It's like, why? They walk up that lane, find everything during the day and they're absolutely fine. I don't see why it's so hard during the night. She went, because they can't see, love. Because you've had them in the bright stables where you've been picking their feet out and giving them a brush and giving them some love and oh, there's some hay nets, or here's the old bucket if you're the one that needs a bucket. And then you're taking them out to the pitch black and their eyes don't adjust as fast. And there's just a bit, it's a bit unsettling for a prey species not to be able to see stuff. But okay. So I'm also a lot more mindful of that. Now, there's not a lot I can do about it because I need to see in the tack room to be able to get their head collars and ropes and stuff like that. I then also can't do anything about the fact that the lights are on motion sensors, which I wouldn't change because they're there for a reason. They do the job brilliantly. And goes to show from last night, I was going to bed and the floodlights came on. And what do I see? Roger, the resident rabbit, with his girlfriend Rowena bounding down the driveway. And I wouldn't change that for anything. But I do need to be mindful of the fact that when I take my horses out in the dark, they're going from light to dark and it's not easy. But it also means that they need to trust me more. And I think that that is relationship building, which is something that we all need to be thinking of because building a relationship with your horse is absolutely amazing. It's magical, and if you get the connection right, it's just a blessing. So I absolutely live for the day when I can go, come on Egypt, come on Pagan, let's go and go for a walk down the lane, knowing that they've gone from a bright yard onto a pitch black lane and they're just happy as Larry to go where I've asked them to because they trust me that much. That'll be the day that I come back dancing and they'll probably be freaked out by it. So, I think the fact that I also do natural horsemanship sort of type activities via Susie of Susie School Horsemanship, it does mean that it's different from the activities that some other people might do. Like, I don't do, what's it called? Circling thingy. Lunging. I don't do lunging because I think that's boring. I find it boring. The horses find it boring. So I don't do it. But if you do that, that's up to you. Rock on. But I do find that there are other activities that other people do that might require the light. I don't know. Obviously, I wouldn't be jumping in the dark. I would if the horse had been in the dark for 40 minutes and we were rocking and rolling and the truss was there, because then it would be for me to trust my horse and go, right, I think there's a jump over there, go find it. Because that is also great for the relationship. Not only are they trusting me, but I am trusting them. So it's a two-way relationship, and that is what I think all of us should be looking for. It's what I look for of the times when I know that I'm freaked out because I know that this is an upsetting situation, like some wanker of a driver shouted at me or beat me on. Oh, I don't like it. I need you not to be freaked out. I need you to go, it's all right, Mum. I got this. We're good. So, yeah, that's why I'm looking for the double-ended relationship of I trust you, you trust me. Yeah. So, yeah, activities in the dark, I don't see why they can't be done. You just got to be mindful of where your horse's eyes are at. And on your own eyes, are you going to have a head torch on your head the entire time you're doing activities with your horse so that you can see? If you do, be mindful of the fact that every now and then you might swipe their eyes with the beam and then you're blinding them for 2 seconds or longer. So be mindful of light in the dark when you're doing horsey activities. Either have what you're doing floodlit or have it dark from the get-go. It'll save you a lot of time, a lot of drama, and then you get to enjoy it. Woo, that was fun. So you get to enjoy it a bit more as well. I mean, your horse can see a lot further in the dark than you can as well. So it's better for them. Never mind. I was going to go off topic then. Let's not go off topic. So I think I'll leave it there. I keep wanting to go off on a tangent, and we don't want tangents today because you just heard I'm coughing. It's not very good for me to talk for too much longer, I don't think. So the latest article is out in the Barefoot Horse magazine, issue 32. I'm in there. My article is all about rose hips, so I hope that you're subscribed to the Barefoot Horse magazine. If you're not, go check it out. Also, while you're in there, read my article. It is freaking awesome, but yes, I am biased. Also, make sure that you are subscribed to the YouTube channel and you click the bell icon so you get a notification for all future videos. Also, make sure that you are connected with us on the Facebook page, join the Facebook group, and check us out on Instagram, @Winactually_Willa, for virtually daily updates on the herd. And I'll see you all next week. Bye.